yes, and I'm coming in. Mm. Yes, Mr. Taylor, is it here? Is it here? Yes. Mm. Yes. Is it really the shop?
Mm.
Why do you ask? I said, is it serious? It must be really one.
Mm.
Did this happen last night? Don't argue anymore. Let's get him where I can lie down on the table and pump the blood out into him.
Mm.
Why is there down here? First thing, take him to him, right down. No, he said, I can't do that. I said, oh, you don't understand. This is my mate.
Yes.
You don't understand, Mr. Overholt, sir. I have the right, I claim this man.
Mm.
He belongs to me.
Mm.
He said, I don't understand any of this. But I must tell you that there are circumstances involving this fatal injury. I said, fatal? Fatal? He isn't dead, he couldn't be. Now, many times you may think people are dead, but if you just take the right action, they'll come back. If you just stop arguing, Mr. Overholt, for God's sake, take me to him and put me on whatever is necessary and get the blood out of me into him. I cannot tell you, Mr. Hyam, how I felt and begged and insisted on that,
mm.
to the point of becoming hysterical.
Yes.
He ushered me into the room. There was Mr. Taylor, lying on the floor. Wonderful features and hands. I've seen so many of these tombs of the fallen warrior.
Knights.
Knights,
yes.
He looked like that. It's covered with a grey silk cover. Mr. Overholt said, I have allowed the upper portion to be undressed so that you could see. And Mr. Overholt left me alone with him for a few moments.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not very tall, I'm not even 5 feet two, mm-hmm. 5 feet one and a half. Little less now in age.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to get up to him,
mm-hmm.
kiss him on the lips,
mm-hmm.
and I couldn't lean over far enough.
Mm-hmm.
But as I touched him, he was cold.
Mm-hmm.
With an incredible coolness. Have you ever touched the departed?
Never, no.
You're not loved either. Not, no description. Former, like, you know how the French use the word l'information, they mean so much more than
yes.
to learn the time of day. To be made aware of something. But convinced me as nothing else could have done. No life can return to this man.
Mm-hmm.
And I stood beside him, holding on, tucking up between his arms, arm, left arm. I was on that side, sobbing wild. Just, oh God, God take me to him. God take me now. Please. Mr. Horsley. And to follow me. I didn't want to go. I want to hold on. Seems to be he went to his office. Gave me some water. I said, who? Who could have done this to me? They crucified Jesus. Now they crucified. They crucified my mate.